Okay, so in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at dividing mixed numbers. So when we've got a question on dividing mixed numbers, what we're going to do first is convert these mixed numbers into improper fractions, to which we're then going to use the keep, flip, change method to divide them. I'll put a link in the description for any other videos that go along with this topic, and also a card in the top corner. So for our first question, we've got 2.5 divided by 1 2/3. So as we previously said, we're going to convert these into improper fractions first. So the denominators will still be the same. So the denominator for the first fraction will still be over 2, and the denominator for the second fraction will still be over 3. We just need to find the numerator now. And the way we do this is we take the denominator of the fraction part of the mixed number and we multiply it by the whole number part. We then add on the numerator of the mixed number. So for this first example, we do 2 multiplied by 2, which is 4. We then add on the 1, which is 5. So 2.5 is equivalent to 5 over 2. We're going to do exactly the same for the next one. We're going to take this 3 and multiply it by the 1. We're then going to add on the 2. So by doing that, we get 3 times 1, which is 3. Add on the 2, which would be 5 as well. So 1 2/3 is equivalent to 5 over 3. So now we're going to do 5 over 2 divided by 5 over 3. Well, when we're dividing fractions, we use the keep, flip, change method. So that means we're going to keep the first fraction as it is. So that will remain as 5 over 2. We're going to flip the second fraction. So 5 over 3 becomes 3 over 5. And then we change the division to a multiplication. So now we've got 5 over 2 multiplied by 3 over 5. So now we're going to see if we can cancel these fractions down. So looking across, first of all, I want to see if I've got a common factor between 2 and 3. We haven't got a highest common factor greater than 1, so I'm going to leave them. So then looking the other way, I've got 5 and 5. Well, the highest common factor of 5 and 5 is actually 5. So we can divide both of these by 5. So I can divide that 5 by 5, and that'll leave us with 1. And also dividing this 5 by 5, that would also give me 1. So now multiplying through, we've got 1 multiplied by 3, which is 3. And then 2 multiplied by 1, which gives us 2. So we want to give our answer as a mixed number. So we've got 3 over 2. To turn that into a mixed number, we want to see how many times 2 fits into 3. Well, that'll fit in 1 full time with a remainder of 1. So our fraction part here would be 1 over 2. So 2.5 divided by 1 2/3 is equivalent to 1.5. Okay, for this next question, we've got 3.5 divided by 2 2/3. So again, the first thing we're going to do is turn these mixed numbers into improper fractions. So I'm going to have a fraction over 2 divided by a fraction over 3. To find the numerator of the first one, I'm going to do 2 multiplied by 3, which is 6. Add on the 1, which will give me 7. So our first improper fraction there would be 7 over 2. Then for the second fraction, we're going to do 3 multiplied by 2, which is 6. Add on the 2 gives us 8. So our second improper fraction there would be 8 over 3. So then to do 7 over 2 divided by 8 over 3, we're going to use the keep, flip, change method. So we're going to keep the 7 over 2. We're going to flip the 8 over 3 so it becomes 3 over 8. We're then changing the division to a multiply. So now we're going to do 7 over 2 multiplied by 3 over 8. So looking across the fractions, we've got 7 and 8. We can't cancel them down. And then the other way, we've got 2 and 3. And there's nothing we can cancel there. So we're just going to multiply these fractions across. So we do 7 multiplied by 3, which gives us 21. And then we've got 2 multiplied by 8, which gives us 16. So now turning our improper fraction into a mixed number, we want to see how many times does 16 fit into 21. Well, that'll fit in 1 full time with the remainder of 5. So our fraction part would be 5/16. So our answer to 3.5 divided by 2 2/3 is 1 5/16. Okay, so we've got some more questions to have a go at now. Feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few seconds. Right, for this question, we've got 2 3/4 divided by 1 1/3. So we want to change these mixed numbers into improper fractions. So we're going to have a fraction over 4 divided by a fraction over 3. So then to find the numerator of the first one, we're going to do 4 times 2, which is 8. add on the 3 gives us 11. So that one there would be 11 over 4. Then for the next fraction, to find the numerator, we would do 3 multiplied by 1, which gives us 3. Add on the 1 gives us 4. So that fraction there would be 4 over 3. We're now going to apply the keep flip change method. So we're going to keep the 11 over 4. We're going to flip the 4 over 3, so it becomes 3 over 4. And then we're going to change the divide to a multiply. So again, we look across the fractions to see if we've got a highest common factor which is greater than 1, which we can cancel these down by. Well, we can't with the 4 and the 3. And there's no common factor greater than 1 with the 11 and 4. So we're going to leave that as it is. And we're just going to multiply them through. So we do 11 times 3, which gives us 33. And then we do 4 times 4, which is 16. So now the final step is converting this 33 over 16 into a mixed number. Well, I want to see how many times does 16 fit into 33? Well, 16 would fit into 33 two whole times, because 2 times 16 is 32, leaving us with the remainder of 1. So our fraction part here would be 1 over 16. So 2 and 3 quarters divided by 1 and a third is equivalent to 2 and 1 16th. For this next question, we've got 3 and 2 thirds divided by 2 and a quarter. Again, our first step here is converting these into improper fractions. So we're going to have a fraction over 3 and then a fraction over 4. So for the numerator on the first one, we're going to do 3 times 3, which is 9. Add on the 2 gives us 11. For the second one, we're going to do 4 times 2, which is 8. Add on the 1 gives us 9. So that would be 9 over 4. Okay, now we're going to apply the keep flip change method. So we've got 11 over 3, which we're going to keep. We're going to flip the 9 over 4, so it becomes 4 over 9. And then we change our divide to a multiply. Again, we look across the fractions here to see if we can cancel these down, if we've got a highest common factor greater than 1. So we haven't got one for 11 and 9 that we can cancel these down by. And we haven't got one for 3 and 4, so we're going to leave that as is. So now multiplying these across, we've got 44 on top. And then 3 times 9 is 27 on the bottom. So then, converting this back to a mixed number, we want to see how many times does 27 fit into 44. Well, 27 fits only once into 44, leaving us with the remainder of 17. So our fraction part here would be 17 over 27. So 3 and 2 thirds divided by 2 and a quarter is equivalent to 1 and 17 27ths. Okay, for this next question, we've got 4 and a half divided by 2 and 5 sixths. So again, first thing we're going to do is convert these to improper fractions. So for our numerator, for our first improper fraction, we do 2 multiplied by 4, which is 8, add on the 1, which gives us 9. So that would be 9 over 2. For our second improper fraction, we're going to do 6 multiplied by 2, which is 12, add on the 5, gives us 17. So that one there would be 17 over 6. Then applying the keep flip change method, we're going to keep our 9 over 2. We're going to flip our 17 over 6, so it becomes 6 over 17. And then we change our divide to a multiply. So again, we check across the fractions now to see if we've got a highest common factor greater than 1. Well, we haven't got a highest common factor greater than 1 for 9 and 17. However, this time we have for 2 and 6, because the highest common factor of 2 and 6 is actually 2. So I'm going to divide both those numbers by 2. So if I do 2 divided by 2, that becomes 1. And if I do 6 divided by 2, that becomes 3. So now multiplying these across, we're going to do 9 times 3, which is 27. Then we've got 1 times 17, which is just 17. So now converting that back into a mixed number, we want to see how many times does 17 fit into 27. Well, it fits in one whole time, leaving us with a remainder of 10. So our fraction part here would be 10 over 17. So 4.5 divided by 2 and 5 sixths is equivalent to 1 and 10 17ths. And for our final question, we've got 4 and 3 quarters divided by 2 and 1 fifth. So again, converting these to improper fractions, we're going to have a fraction over 4 divided by a fraction over 5. For the numerator for the first one, we do 4 times 4, which is 16. Add on the 3 gives us 19, so that would be 19 over 4. And then for our second fraction, we do 5 times 2, which is 10. Add on the 1 gives us 11. So that would be 11 over 5. Then applying the keep flip change method, we're going to keep our 19 over 4. We're going to flip our 11 over 5 so it becomes 5 over 11. We then change the divide to a multiply. So again, we check across the fractions now to see if we can cancel these down. There's no highest common factor greater than 1 for 19 and 11, or for 4 and 5. So we're going to leave that as it is and then just multiply across. So 19 multiplied by 5 gives us 95, and then 4 times 11 gives us 44. So now converting to a mixed number, we want to see how many times does 44 fit into 95? Well, it'll fit in 2 times because 2 times 44 is 88, leaving us with a remainder of 7. So our fraction part here would be 7 over 44. So 4 and 3 quarters divided by 2 and 1 fifth is equivalent to 2 and 7 44ths. So well done if you followed along with those questions, and that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.